intelligent football. Denyman deep in the pocket, about 5 metres in from the line. That's a couple of times now Denyman's put the ball out of bounds. Just dropping it carelessly onto the boot, not taking his time. And as a result, the Swans will get a chance to relieve pressure. It'll be Roberts deep in his own defensive area. Stoneham is coming back onto the ground. I wouldn't be at all surprised if Denyman is coming off.
Roberts from the back pocket. Again, hugging that outer boundary line. Flanagan forced to defend. Ball comes to ground. No one able to get it clear. Eventually, Cordy gets a hurried kick, but it goes straight over the line.
Denyman now playing in the forward pocket for Geelong, and Darren Troy, who was further up the ground, has taken his place in the back pocket.
Just 1 point the margin. Healy trying desperately to get into the game. Murphy. And there, I believe, will be the first 50-metre penalty for the day. And it brings Murphy from the half-back line to Sydney's 50-metre attacking line. Greg Williams giving him advice to have a go long. So he lets fly with a torpedo punt kick that's going to land in the square and then fisted over the line.
Dwayne Russell. Sorry, Sandy, but
pleasure.
Dwayne Russell coming off for Geelong and coming on as Stoneham back to that centre half forward position.
Here's the throw in. Healy. Mighty fist, bit of aerial ping pong work going on at the moment. Bairstow going over the top of Paul.
Oh.
Boy, gee, there's some interesting. What's your decisions going on?
Well, Bairstow was just playing the ball. That was a very tough decision, I thought.
What do you think, Tom?
Yes, it's a case of what is your decision? Oh, yes, I've got to agree with you. I would have just said play on.
Yep.
When in doubt, let the game flow.
So this gives Morwood a chance to give Sydney a 7-point break. He hits the post.
Perhaps justice.
The margin is now 2 points.
That breeze has fallen away. 14-12 remaining in the term. Darcy, a little indecisive. Where will he go? Grandstand side. Intended for Stoneham. Up he goes, couldn't hang on. Runs, well tackled by Wright. Hand pass comes out from Hocking. Denham's got it, taken high surely. And Denham will get the free kick. And the crowd getting right into this game now. Denham swings it out wide. Here's danger. Hughes a playmaker. He's up from the back pocket. Runs away. Goes deeper to the forward line. Ablett's in front looking for the free kick. Carter punches away. It's taken by Drum. Drum the hand pass goes straight up in the air.
Oh,
Ablett.
Now that is a...
Yes, you're right. Away comes Healy. He was held without it, Ablett. This is Murphy. He's in trouble. Hand passes out wide. And is going to get the free. Yes, he will. So the crowd not very happy at all with the umpiring displays of Harris and Hallett.
Well, that one is a free kick. We'll agree on that one. But I thought Gary Ablett could have got one.
Murphy to the outer side then. Almost a clever mark to Williams. Denham. Williams back over the ball now. That's holding the ball.
Well, I think Greg Williams will realise when he's in the game because the crowd will be against him. He'll receive the Bronx cheer, but yet he hasn't.
Back towards half forward, the Denham kick. Murphy didn't do much with the ball. Wright is slung. They're going in very solidly. Drum has hold of the ball, and the umpire will move in to ball it up.
On the 50-metre line, on the line. Kicks high, it may be a fraction wide. As Healy's taken the mark anyway. No one on the mark, so he gets clear. Boss coming over the top. Bairstow waiting at the back. Battiston well tackled. The ball is held this time, the umpire said.
Held to him this time, eh? course it was.
So another ball up. Flanagan, Denham, Bairstow. The Cats into attack. Up towards full forward, Ablett and Carter. And the shepherding by Carter allows Coleman to take the mark. Thrip over the top of Bruns, waiting down Drum to Couch, who's starting to come into the game. He's usually a prolific kick winner. The full forward again. Now, is that within 5 metres? I think Gary Ablett is starting to get a little frustrated. What are your thoughts on this, Don?
Well, he's got to start and lead more, Sandy. He can't try and use his body as he's been doing on the last couple of occasions.
Certainly some feeling in this game. Bairstow brings it back into play. Denham takes the mark. Short to half. Oh, he's got loose players there, Couch.
Ooh,
now, is that 50 metres?
Come on, umpire.
We saw on Friday night at the MCG something like 750-metre penalties given out, and many of them were for instances of far less significance than that. However, Couch from 50 metres. It's a good-looking kick. Has he got the accuracy? I think he has.
The Australian family holiday. Even better with a family car you can rely on. Nissan Pintara. Pintara easily completed the Nissan 600,000K Endura, and it's backed by Nissan's 2-year warranty, which makes Nissan Pintara the ideal 4-cylinder Australian family car.
That's what my dad says, Mr. Thompson.
That's right, mate. Nissan, building the right cars for Australia.
Holiday Australia at the caravan and camping show. Here's your passport to see the places you probably want to go. You could win prizes really grand, a NASCAR for the kids, a Viscount caravan.
This year's caravan and camping show is going to be bigger and better than ever. On entry, you'll receive this passport for travel through a recreated Australia, which will be stamped in each state. You could discover the perfect spot for your next holiday and win fabulous prizes. You'll see the latest in caravans, campers, mobile homes, and America's latest recreational vehicle, the Jayco Fifth Wheeler. Yes, there's something for everyone in this year's Caravan and Camping Show. Don't miss out.
Come and see the latest in camping and caravans. The Fifth Wheeler from the USA. Pop tops and tents that expand. It's on now at the exhibition buildings. You know where to go. Holiday Australia at the Caravan and Camping Show.
On now.
Lightly salted, delicately sliced Smith's Lights. The daintiest way to stuff your face.
Good afternoon, Kate Dunstan in the Seven Newsroom. Tonight, a Mooney Ponds family confronted by a Pentridge escapee in their own home speaks out about their ordeal. Polling begins quietly in New Caledonia as the French province votes in the presidential election, and a woman arrested at a Canberra church just before the Queen was due to attend a service. Peter Mitchell joins me for Seven Nightly News at 6. See you then.
Play restarts. Geelong back in front by 4 points. Williams comes away from the centre, kicks towards half forward. It's taken by Mitchell to Thrip. It needs a kick. Thrip at right half forward, goes down towards the pocket. It pitches just inside the line and runs out of bounds. Williams has had 5 kicks and 4 hand passes so far.
And Denham shading little Barry Murphy. So obviously they're playing out of the back pocket, the Rovers.
Flanagan interferes with Brown, did he? No, off the ball. It's a free kick to Mitchell. Denham was hanging on. Denham pleading his case, but Mitchell will get the ball and kick from inside 50. It should simply be a question of accuracy from here.
The Swans trailing. Harry Mitchell. Goes Goldwood, slides it across the face, I fancy. They contest right on the goal line. It's fisted through for a behind. So the margin now, 3 points in favour of Geelong. And the breeze is starting to come up again now. Died out for about the first 10 minutes or so of this term. Short one comes into Hocking. There's Hocking, inside half-back, sends play towards the outer side wing, pack into the air, knocked Geelong's way, but only as far as Thripp. He's confronted by Couch. This is Murphy, good tackle by Stoneham, it's jarred free. Carroll gets it across to support, Coleman going nowhere. Lockman has it now from Williams, intercepting Denham, hand passes in the direction of the opposition. Carroll gets it across to Mitchell. It's tough stuff in there. Short kick finds Battiston. Battiston goes very short. The tumbling Thripp takes the mark.
Full-rudded runs at the ball in the centre then, Dennis, from both sides.
Thripp. 60 metres out. Short. More with the target. He has possession now. Needs support, gets it. Mitchell's kick for goal. Fair looking kick, and he's kicked it.
Well, as soon as it left Barry Mitchell's boot, he knew he'd kick the goal. He jumped in the air, the clenched fist, sign that he was very, very happy the way that ball left the boot. And he has his third goal, and now the Sydney Swans 3 points in front. But it wasn't a good kick going deep into that pocket, but Morwood in front, let it, got it, and quickly hand passed it to Mitchell, the little fellow.
So Sydney at the moment answering the challenge. From the centre, it's Bairstow trying to get Geelong into attack once again. Couch goes wide. Cordy has a chance here. But superior pace being shown by Denham. Back in towards Couch. After a quiet first half, he's really come into it. Drum long for Turner this time. Over the back, Turner recovers well, can give it to Ablett. No, he has a snap on his left foot, and perhaps the hand pass could have been on.
I think it was on.
So, out of bounds. Geelong's left forward pocket. Stoneham taken out of it. Denham to Bewes. Well, now he's saying he threw it. So it'll be a free kick going the way of Sydney, plus 50 metres, and it's Coleman. So all of a sudden, Sydney have a chance to go into attack again. Hocking virtually threw that one, and it landed with Holden. Out towards Morwood, takes it on with the one hand. Sydney running hot at the moment. They lead by 3 points. The leads of Brown and Davis ignored. Morwood. Not sure what to do. He'd waited till Healy had just snuck away a little.
That's that hole, Sandy.
That's the hole that he found.
The ruckman should be there blocking that hole. That short kick's always on. And we saw North Melbourne Friday night utilise the hole beautifully.
So Healy. A chance to give Sydney a 9-point lead, but he's pushed that one across the face of goal and one behind. 4 points the margin in a torrid, tough game of football. Sydney 11-10, Geelong 11-6.
6:06 remaining in this term. Darcy put it back into play. Slightly favouring the outer side is the kick, ill-directed. The mark is taken uncontested by Murphy. The Swans looking good in this term. Murphy down towards the pocket. Brown is the target. Darcy the leaper. Brown too tall. And this young fellow has been impressive, particularly on a lead today. And he comes out in front. He's very hard to move off the ball. As evidence there, Darcy really didn't know how to handle that one. David Brown, a name you'll hear more of. It's not a bad kick either. It's on its way. It looks pretty good. That's a fine effort by the young fella. Brown gets the goal.
The phone bill? I thought you were going to pay that out of your cheque account.
Well, there's no money left in it.
Well, use the other one.
I can't touch that for about another month.
But it's your money, Ralph.
Yes, but then the interest
won't. But it's still your money.
When the state bank launched the state banking system, it put 400,000 Victorians back in control of their money.
Well, let's pull some out of your interest-bearing deposit.
If you're still out of control, come and see us.
You've got to wait 90 days for that one.
So what were you saying about your money?
So, 2 years overseas and he thinks he can tell us how to run things. Well, we won't have it.
It's all right. I fix things. He's travelling overnight.
Not first class.
No. Business class, of course. Company policy.
By the time he gets in, he'll be exhausted. And he won't have had time to incorporate those new figures I sent him in his report.
He'll be hungry and tired.
I've arranged for the chauffeur to bring him straight here, not to the hotel.
Like a lamb to the slaughter, gentlemen.
Morning.
New Club World delivers the businessman ready to do business.
Pleasant trip.
Yes, thank you.
New Club World, from the world's favourite airline.
Discover the wonderful world of Saba Furniture Exhibition and Warehouse Sales. Undoubtedly the largest quality furniture display. A whole world of furniture and bedding just waiting to be explored. For example, lounge suites, bedroom suites. And discover the luxurious world of Saba Leather Living. So much to choose from and everything so reasonably priced and all under the one roof. Saba offers 1 year, yes, 1 year interest-free terms and free delivery anywhere in Victoria, New South Wales and South Australia. 1 year interest-free plus a written guarantee. No reasonable offer refused and admission is free. Take a stroll through Saba Furniture Exhibition and Warehouse Sales. You'll never know what you'll find. Saba, Frankston Road, Dandenong and Branches. Come and say hello to Dave and Mabel at Saba Furniture Exhibition and Warehouse Sales. Corner of Greens Road and Frankston Road, Dandenong. Open 9 till 9 Monday to Friday and 9 till 5 Saturday.
We're back in the centre. One of the biggest breaks they've had, in fact, their biggest for the Swans. They lead it by 10 points. That man again, Bairstow, he'll go long. Now he goes in short instead. The options were there. Ablett on the lead, has the ball well within range. He'll kick from about 45 metres out. I thought momentarily Bairstow would go towards a vacant goal square. But Ablett, very speedy on the lead. He's kicked four so far, Gary Ablett. A live wire on the forward line. What can he do from here? Distance shouldn't be a problem. Ablett, the study and concentration. Goes Goldwood, and he's missed to the right-hand side. 9 points the difference.
Kick then. He's just coming up a little bit. Sydney will come home with it. The Sydney side is desperate for a win after the events of the recent week, now under new ownership. And determined to do well. Carroll to court. Plays on quickly to Williams. Tui at centre wing. Sydney go forward again very quickly to Morwin.
Oh, great kick.
Morwin from 70 metres, but he's got Holden in that hole again. He can play off. Just chips one. Looking for Brown, he's got it.
Ah.
He just put a vice-like grip on that football and will now have a shot 30 metres out, almost directly in front.
Won't be celebrating in Pennant Hills, I would imagine.
This is a great mark there. Just too big for Tim Darcy. Darcy was in the right position, but the big arms of David Brown came over the top and clocked him. Nice mark.
Brown going for goal number four. Let's see what he can do. He's kicked it. So the Sydney Swans move clear.
Well, this quarter belongs to that young fellow receiving a pat on the bottom from Craig Davis. And there we see on replay, good play. Four goals, three in this quarter from Pennant Hills. He's only 20 years of age. Looks like he's about 6 foot six.
And what a difference.
The old measurement.
When Ablett has a set shot at goal, he misses. It's all Sydney Swans possession down the ground. Bang, goal. Centre bounce again. 15 points the margin. Now the question being asked, can the Cats come back? Murphy hooks it over his shoulder, down to the half-forward line, Morwood. They're playing inspired football at the moment. Brown is in the square. He elects to go short. Mitchell can play on, shoot towards goal, and bang!
Oh, it drifted.
Gee, it did drift too, didn't it?
Left to right. Slice. Dwayne Russell warming up. Geelong about to make a change, obviously.
16 points the margin. Favouring Sydney. Suddenly, this Geelong crowd has quiet. Darcy, straight down the middle. Flanagan playing behind, however. Coleman in front.
This marking has been sensational, hasn't it?
He'll kick from 50, trying to get behind a big torpedo.
Forward.
He hasn't got it. Troy. Over the head of Buse, but it's 3-1. Lockman. To right. On the boundary line, Williams. Chips back in, but there's two Geelong players there. And it's Tim Darcy on the very last line of defence. Gets the handball away. The kick is very wide. And just bounces inside the line. So a throw-in to take place. But the Geelong defence now under all sorts of pressure.
Sydney running hot.
On the 50-metre line. Mitchell. Battiston. Taken off the football. Lyons the call, drum clear. Boss, a hurried one into the centre. The back was Carroll, so too Coleman. What are his options? He decides to swing round and kick it himself. No mark taken, no free kick. Geelong fans looking for it on drum. He's still going. Gets it out the back to Darcy. He's in trouble. Put his teammate under a fraction more trouble. No one able to get it out. And the umpire's got to come in and have it.
And Geelong have made the move. Tim Darcy now picking up the ball has been moved out on the half-back line. And Michael Schultz has gone to full-back on David Brown.
Without wishing to be a prophet of doom, of course, Sydney haven't run out their games in recent weeks. Their fourth quarter's been their weakness. Can they do it today? They'll turn it three-quarter time with a handy lead. The ball on the forward line. Right, looking to extend that lead. 50 metres out, chips it across towards Morwood. And Morwood's taking a courageous mark. Forward going back in one explored territory there has marked about 30 metres out on a slight angle. Stoneham is coming off the ground. Russell is coming back on. Strange because 55 seconds remains in the term. I doubt Russell will get too many possessions. Here's Morwood. He's got it straight through the middle. What a turn by the Swans. He's kicked four.
Today's game is a part of the Elders IXL 1988 VFL Premiership season.
So Geelong led by 16 points at quarter time, 3 points at half time. But thanks to newcomer David Brown and veteran Tony Moore, the Swans kicking 6-5 to Geelong's 2-4 to lead by 22 points at three quarter time. So the big question was, could the Sydney Swans hold on for their second win of the year? Or would it be Geelong coming back in front of their home crowd, the wind dying down in the final quarter, but still a big task in front of the Cats? We'll be back with a thrilling last quarter action after this break on Sunday Replay.
When it comes to your insurance, there's a name you need to know.
I've been insured with SIO for years. Not long ago, I had an accident. A bad one. The car was a write-off. Boy, was I glad I had an SIO agreed value policy. Instead of just getting market value, which could have been a much lower figure, I got back the full sum insured from SIO with no hassles. So if you have an accident, big or small, it's great to know with SIO, you'll be well looked after.
At SIO, caravan insurance comes complete with a big discount of up to 34%.
If you need a locksmith, do what I do.
Use the Melbourne Big. It's much faster.
The Melbourne Big, the buying guide Melbourneians are turning to.
In even the cleanest house, bacteria breed. Luckily, there's a sensitive instrument that tells us where. It's called the human nose. You see, bacteria cause most household smells. Smells air fresheners only cover up. But disinfectant Glen 20 kills bacteria, and that kills smells for good. So trust your nose and Glen 20. Glen 20 kills the bacteria that cause the smells.
Austin, the 50s.
You like your music with a touch of country. Here's a touch of country magic. All the country greats. Dolly Parton.
Jolene, 16
tracks with just the right amount of country flavor. There's Willie Nelson, Kenny Rogers, Waylon Jennings, Charlie Pride, and many more. Be quick for a touch of country magic on record, cassette and compact disc.
In stores now from Dino Music.
Tonight on ALF.
Paul still lucky.
Fuzzball's creating havoc.
I still got it.
Is he cracking up?
Not particularly.
Going stir crazy.
That piece doesn't fit there.
Yes, it does.
That's ALF at 7:30. And right after, the Hogans have a visitor.
What an awful woman.
She's just a character.
Yeah, out of a book by Stephen King.
Top comedy tonight on 7.
Welcome back to Sunday Replay. Well, the stage certainly set for a great last quarter down there at Cardinia Park, but the Sydney Swans certainly in the box seat with that tremendous third quarter burst towards the end of the third quarter, and they went into the last break with a fairly substantial advantage. But Geelong, with their big home crowd roaring for them, certain to put up a great effort. It was to turn out to be a magnificent last quarter of football. We rejoin the action with about 19 minutes remaining on the clock, and at this stage, Sydney lead by 23 points.
The veteran, Rod Carter, deep in his own defensive area. Comes along the grandstand wing. In front, Darcy, good strong mark. He'll send it back. Man on in the middle, that's Troy. And he finds him. Troy is a very good player. Pushing up the ground now, these defenders. Giving Geelong some numbers. And Troy will kick from about 50 metres out. There is no 50-metre penalty there. Some of the crowd thought there should have been.
Two pretty tough customers. Darren Troy on screen and standing the mark, Greg Williams.
Short intended for Bairstow. He telegraphed it. Murphy almost hands it across to Healy. Williams, he's starting to get into this game. As Don told you, taken high. He'll get the free kick. Williams, the playmaker, has been given some room. He's at half back. Again, taking his time. Centres the ball. Up in front is Cordy. Off hands, an opportunity now for Geelong. The hand pass comes to Bairstow. It came from Drum. And it goes. Ablett is up. Off hands, Turner goes looking for Scott, but the mark is paid.
Well, that handball came unstuck. I thought they may have paid the advantage. The handball came unstuck off screen. And luckily the umpire said, Gary Ablett, you've got to go back for your kick. What a good mark by Ablett. You see there, just getting the break, strong in the air. He holds his body well in the air and not brushed easily off the ball.
He's kicked four. I think he snuck this one in. He has. Five. For Gary Ablett.
With a good kick off the boot by Gary Ablett, the broken knee and the ankle a little bit floppy after he kicked the ball. There was really no purpose. He was guiding the ball, really. He should really start and kick through it. But again, showing up the strength of Gary Ablett despite the opposition from Rod Carter. There's the kick. Very loose lower leg.
So is Geelong back in business again. 17 points is the margin. Cordy tries to bash his way through. He can't. Bairstow can. Short little chip pass is good to Turner. Well, the crowd suddenly come alight, chanting and cheering and thumping their chairs.
They're parochial, aren't they, down here at Geelong,
yes,
Sandy?
They love their football. Let's see what happens this time. Turner kicks in towards goal. I think he's missed it. Well, they've had opportunities.
That was a very big kick, that one. Two goals in the space of 60 seconds really would have applied the pressure.
So, the Sydney Swans live again. In towards the centre it goes. The mark, is it not going to be paid? It is not. Play on is the call. The fans don't like it.
Cordy gets it clear to Healy. Healy lets fly with a torp up towards the left half forward flank. No mark taken. Who's waiting down? In trouble is Deneman. Wright has been quiet. Sees it over the line with Boss. Davis looks in a spot of bother. Throw in. Plenty of hanging on. Mitchell's at the bottom of the pack. Williams held. And another ball up to take place. Real pressure. It's tough and it's hard. Exciting football with Sydney holding a 16-point lead. But still, with almost 16 minutes remaining, it's anyone's game. Denneman, a hurried kick. Toohey pushed into the ball. And a great one-hander. Plays on to Carroll. Sydney steadying. Williams is starting to come into the game and he's on that half-forward line.
With hindsight, Don, I think you were right.
Greg Williams.
Just too elusive for Darren Troy. Got a lot to say when he's got a kick for goal, hasn't he?
Well, he's 46 or 7 metres is where he'll kick from. With a torpedo putt. In towards goal it goes, and he's kicked it. A steadier for the Sydney Swans. Williams kicks his first, and what a handy one for Sydney. 16-12, 108, leading Geelong, 13-8, 86. Is it enough, Don?
Well, maybe Greg Williams put himself under a bit of pressure early on in the game, but he has been a really good player, starting to come into it. In actual fact, the funny thing about it is in 1985, he was Geelong's best and fairest player. And here he is playing against that side. Last year, Sid.
Play restarts. 108 to 86. Greg Williams kicking a goal. And he kicks it out of the centre. That last goal could well be a franchise saver. This is Couch. He breaks away. Goes towards half forward. The Cats aren't spent yet. Flanagan's got it. Run down by Carroll. Back it comes, picked up by Cordy. He's been resolute throughout the day, but this time he kicks it out of bounds on the full. Flanagan will get the resultant kick on the outer side. It's pretty cool now at Cadinia Park. It's hot out there in the middle. Tough game of football, this one. Cordy comes over the top and gets it out of bounds. We'll have a boundary throw in. No, it's going to be a free kick to hold it in front for a push in the back. The umpires have not endeared themselves to the Geelong supporters today. Craig Holden, who's been a valuable player, up from the back pocket, kicks towards centre wing. It's a high kick on the breeze. Burke, uncontested, takes the mark. Can the skipper spark the Cats? Sweeping hand pass. Couch wants his left side. Cuts through the oncoming Swans and goes down towards full forward. Ablett waiting behind. Oh. Fisted away down there by Cordy.
Yes, good decision.
It's going to be a free kick in front to Drum.
Good decision. Sorry, Dennis, but a good decision. Can't help but get carried away. It's a good game.
Well called, Don. No, I don't mind if you get carried away at all. Drum's got the ball just in from the boundary. No doubt about that kick. Damien Drum. What can he do? A kick from just inside 50. A lot of pressure on this kick. I'll probably contest in the square. He's exposed to the breeze out there. A little indecisive. There goes his kick. It's falling in short. The ball tumbles across the boundary line. I think off the fingertips there of Turner, or was it a behind? It just snuck through for a behind. And Drum's not too happy.
You see, he wasn't too confident in kicking for goal. Had a couple of attempts.
Well, he didn't fill you with confidence, did he, as he came in? There goes Carroll. Long, telling kick. Christensen thumps it away for Geelong. Tries to kick it out of midair. Healy goes in with courage. And he's going to get a free kick.
50, 50.
Don's umpiring one heck of a game. You're calling him all right, Don.
So, this has immediately put Sydney in the box seat. Healy has gone from the half back line. He's kicking from 60 metres out. Oh. And Brown again has taken the mark.
On a lead, he looks anything, doesn't he?
Tucked in the pocket. Distance won't be a problem. Accuracy maybe.
I think he looks anything anyway, Dennis, whether he's leading or marking. He's a real athlete.
David Brown going for goal number five. And this could just about be a sealer. But it won't be because he's gone into the man on the mark. Buse now under pressure, goes over the top. They won't keep it in, however. And so a throw in to take place. Well, the pressure being felt by all. Sydney desperate for a win. Geelong fighting for a place in the five. Williams caught, tried to storm his way through, couldn't quite do so, and it's immediately tapped directly over the line. Greg Williams calls for deliberate, but the umpire will have none of it.
And Andy Buse is now picking up Greg Williams.
Here's the throw-in. Burke obviously enjoys ruck work because he's going to do that all again.
It's not good play, Damien. You do that when you're in front and hanging on.
Here it is again. Down towards Bruns and Murphy. It's the latter who wins out. But his handball to Mitchell is dropping a little low. He was under pressure. And it went over the line. So again, it will be Burke and Brown. Won by Burke. Pushed down the front to Buse. Over the top to Bruns. He's got nothing, so he's got to kick it. It'll drop short, however, to Flanagan. Back to the running Bairstow. Geelong needs something positive here. Turner and Ian Roberts. Turner one grab. Neither can take it. At the back is Ablett. He kicks towards goal. How's it going to bounce? Well off target. And one behind. Tom Devine. Gary Ablett. 20 points the margin. Cut. Short but straight down the middle. And effective. Batterston. High and wide. Buse at the back. Williams with him. Hughes gets front spot. Can he get clear, though? Oh, he's still going. Well played, Hughes. He got clear of two of them, and then his kick in towards half forward. A fine tackle by Healy. Sees the ball drop loose, but it's still with Geelong. Taken by Hughes again. Ablett and Carter. Ablett, front spot. Turner can do the roving. He can just got to pick it up, and he's gone, and he has.
Hey, take a look at this week's Aussie Post. There's the tragic story of a little boy dying from a rare disease believed to have been passed on by a stray cat. We visit the $21 million prison they say is more like an upmarket motel, and the parents of a young murder victim demand justice as they fight to clear their son's name. We take a look at the Aussie stars who refuse to fade away, the beauty queen who reigns behind the bar, and the mum and daughter team taking on the big boys in the cattle breeding game. Aussie Post, the great Australian magazine, on sale Monday.
It whisks without a cord. It blends without a cord. It beats without a cord.
It's the all-new rechargeable cordless WhizMix from Breville, with two-speed finger touch control and no power cord to get in the way. Recharging is automatic. You simply replace it on its stand.
New Breville WhizMix, the rechargeable mixer that beats anything you can eat.
Kids love their granny.
I have picnics with my granny.
Our granny's away with the jumbos.
My granny makes me laugh.
Nothing matches the wholesome traditional value of Granny Davis.
I like my granny with eggs on her. I put hundreds and thousands on my granny.
Granny Davis jumbo loaves. Always fresh, always delicious.
I love my granny.
Getting the job done with ease is simple when you have the right equipment. And having the right equipment is as simple as a phone call to Door to Door Hire. Door to Door Hire deliver the equipment you need right to your door or site, complete with instructions and ready for use, and pick it up when you're finished. At Door to Door Hire, a day's hire is 24 hours, not the normal 8 hours, and on some items, delivery is no extra charge. Open 7 days a week, Door to Door Hire are in St Kilda, Surrey Hills and North Melbourne. So call Door to Door Hire and get the job done with ease.
Lightly salted, delicately sliced Smith's Lights, the daintiest way to stuff your face.
Points the difference. Burke out at the centre.
9:54 remains in the game. Coming through is Roberts. He boots it towards half forward, knocked away by Hocking. Henneman leads in the race. He sockers towards the boundary line. That's been his forte all day, one way or another. It's out of bounds and we'll have a throw in.
Well, Sydney have used their interchange bench for the first time with Higgins coming on. Fresh legs, that's what they need.
16-12, plays 14-10 in the gathering gloom here at Cadinia Park. Trippers over the ball to Mitchell. Mitchell has his kick blanketed. It's missed out there by Troy. He goes again, spills wide, socket off the ground. Mitchell was the player, sliding in is Williams, knocked out by Bruns. Troy, towards centre field comes the kick. Lockman gets a fist on Scott. Scott goes after the ball, dribbles run about 5 metres. White picks it up, out wide towards right half forward and Williams. He's been a star in this final term. Higgins.
Great tackle.
Well claimed by Denham, taken high, says the umpire. First blemish for you, Don. Higgins has got the ball down towards right half forward. Kick towards the pocket. Morwood didn't take the mark. Almost holding the ball. Geelong have got the numbers. This is Buse. Steadies. He runs it out. Buse towards the outer side. Swans have got the numbers. Cordy over the top. Thumps it forward. Tui in a fine player. Higgins giving them legs now. Higgins goes down towards the pocket. He was met solidly. And the ball is pushed out of bounds by Boss.
The umpire very lucky not to pay. Down the ground there, a rather late tackle on the Sydney Swans as they went forward then.
14 points the margin. The umpire coming and having a chat to a few players. It's pretty hot out there on the ground. 14 points, Sydney in attack, a goal here, and it might just about spell the end because there's just over 8 minutes of this match remaining to the 50-metre defensive line. Carroll can't take it, neither can Flanagan. Mitchell caught, drops the football, socket off the ground, wide to Murphy, can't pick it up, however. Slippery ball, it's very difficult. Couch is on top of him, Bairstow through, so too Bruns. Scott, if he's clear, they can get it to him, but no, they've got to wait. Troy now will find Scott. He can run on. He can run on. Over the top, he can go to Turner or head towards goal. Well, he's gone as long as he can, and it gave Cordy time to get back and push it defensively over the line.
Inexperience on that kick from Scott. It had to be in short. Turner had to come back to the ball because he exposed it to Cordy, and Cordy played it brilliantly. So Carter.
Compliments to the umpires. They're now letting the game go, adding to the spectacle.
That's because they're agreeing with you. Carter's kick.
That's a first. Fist it down. Still a chance. It's Bairstow again. Long in towards full forward. Oh. It's a free kick.
Has to be Ablett.
This is going to make the margin, if he's successful, 7 points. And look at John Devine.
Wistful.
Serenity.
I don't know if we caught this on camera here, but I thought Gary Ablett could have been caught behind. Oh, no, I can see Rod Carter pulling the jumper. Good decision, umpire.
You get the feeling Don's after Brownlow.
Let's see what happens. It's a critical kick. Can Ablett cut the margin by 6 points? He can. Ablett has kicked goal number six, and the Cats won't lie down yet.
7 points the difference. Ablett has kicked his sixth goal. What good umpiring on that occasion. I would have let the game go on, but the umpire picked it out. Very observant work, because he was at least 40 metres behind play there. And Ablett, we can see there on screen, being spun around by Rod Carter at the critical moment. But we've got a game on our hands here.
Sydney lead by 7 points. 7 minutes exactly remaining in the game. Plenty of time for Geelong. They work it forward yet again. Murphy collides with Couch. It spills to Tui, to Healy. High kick to half forward. Up was Darcy, knocking away from Tripp. This is Higgins to Wright. 50 metres out from goal, right. Down towards full forward. Vic Brown is down there. Fisted away by Schulz. Awkward bounce for Hocking. They're going in solidly. It's out of bounds in the right full forward pocket.
Good body work by Michael Schulz.
It's been an outstanding competitive game of football all day long, this one. Fitting it should end this way. Over the top, Burke. Taken by Williams. Mitchell deep in the pocket. Pulls it back across his body. It bounces across the face of goal. Hocking leads back in the race.
goes in short. Bronzy stretches and takes the mark. Wants to go. Back to Hocking.
Whoops.
Bairstow out of space. Gives it away. Healy's got the run of it now. Surrounded. It comes across to Toohey. These players now simply playing on instinct through the fingertips of Hocking. Davis, the veteran, 40 metres out. He's kicked a goal.
Well, Craig Davis, has he put the nail in the coffin? Maybe a better effort could have been expected of Hocking on that occasion. He had to take that ball. And I think he could have, but Craig Davis, right on the job. He doesn't make too many mistakes now, Craig. Oh, here's this ball again from Toohey. Now we see Hocking underneath. Maybe you could attribute that to the pressure put on by Tony Morwood. Davis, very jubilant, hands in the air. 13 points the difference.
Now the pressure back on the home side, Geelong. Can they get it out of the middle? Bruns has the opportunity. He's looking for the free kick, trying desperately to get it clear with a short one. He does. Cordy is there, however. So too Holden. Carroll kicks high in the air, partly smothered off the boot. Play on will be the call. No one able to get it clear, and the umpire has no alternative but to come in and bounce. The shadows lengthening and darkness starting to fall over the ground. 5 minutes remaining, just over. And 13 points the margin. Geelong need the next one, and they need it pretty quickly. They've got the chance. Bruns is on the end of the chain. Go long, and he does. Abler comes out. He's got it. Gary Abler going for goal number 7.
Bruns on screen now. Another intelligent pass.
Here's Abler. The drop punt's on its way. It's going right across the face of goal and out of bounds on the 4.
Well, sometimes his kicking can let him down, Gary Ablett, and it did on that occasion.
So a little more respite for Sydney. Toohey will be the flyer, taking a good mark.
Played well today.
Bernard Toohey in the back pocket. Slowing things right down. Drifted into Lachman at half-back. Players streaming everywhere at the moment. There's a lot of tired players out there. Carter and Ablett. Who's going to recover first? It's going to be Carter. He's up and running towards the boundary line, but it beats him. And so a throw-in to take place.
Well, Geelong have got nobody to blame except themselves for this position that they're in at the moment. Third quarter scoring only 16 points. That was the quarter they lost it if they're going to lose.
There's still time if they're good enough. Here they come again. The hand pass finishes with Bairstow. He's loose. He fires at goal, but he's off target, I fear, again. Another behind. Well, now they want 2 straight goals to draw this game. They've got 3.5 minutes to do it. Cordy to bring it back into play. Going to the outer side. Coleman is his target, waiting down Scott. He gets it clear. Can Couch pick it up? In fact, it's Denham. He's kicking towards Turner. Almost plucked it. Another smother. Ablett on the ground now. Still fighting for it. Sockers it clear. Trying to get it to Turner. He does so. Back to Ablett. A hurried snap into the pocket. Very, very close to the line and now taken over. Oh, gee, she's hot out there.
Great game of football.
3 minutes remaining, Don.
Competitive stuff.
Here's the throw-in. Coleman trying to push it away from that scoring zone. Williams and the handball to Mitchell. He's still going along with it. As long as they can get it away outside that 50-metre line, they realise they're in a relatively safe position.
Good effort then by young Mitchell to force the ball, and also good opposition from Damien Drum.
Here's the throw-in again, and again a mighty fist sends it clear, but it goes to Bruns. Shepherding will see them clear. Scott in trouble. He goes short, but it wasn't a well-directed one for Bairstow. The left footer, Couch nips in. Snaps at goal, but he's pulled it badly as well. Well, doing all the peppering, Dennis.
They can't finish it off. Looking at that look on John Devine, they've almost finished him off. What can you do? Nothing at all as coach now. It's in the hands of the players. Marvellous game as Carter kicks in, long kick. Birkin from the side couldn't take the mark. It falls behind. This is Hocking. Just over 2 minutes remain. Back to centre half forward. Flanagan is up. Can't hang on at the second attempt. Taken by Carter. Or rather, Coleman. Coleman gets it across to Mitchell. Mitchell towards centre wing. Brown couldn't hang on. Darcy lays it off to Troy. Chips it out wide to Bruns. He'll have to move now, Bruns. But Clock, the enemy of Geelong, he goes down towards half forward. Dropped down there by Couch on his knee as he hand passes to Flanagan. Flanagan waiting to be tackled. Now the rule is he must make an attempt. He didn't actually there. We won't get technical though. The ball will be bounced on about the 50-metre line. 1:36 and counting down.
Sydney have got to defend around the boundary line.
Rucks go to it. Storming his way through is Williams. He read that brilliantly off hands. Darcy to Bruns. Bruns hooks it back despite a valiant attempt to smother by Williams. Scott got his hand to it. This is Couch. Couch to Denham. Last roll of the dice coming up for Geelong. Can they make a goal of this? Denham down towards full forward. One out contest down there. Turner works his way to the front. He's taken the mark. Turner's taken the mark. 5 metres out, 63 seconds and counting down in this game. Michael Turner knows that. Wasting no time, he gets the goal. And they creep within one goal now, Geelong. The difference is only 5 points. 17-12 Sydney, 16-13 Geelong. 49 seconds remaining in the game.
The Geelong chant is up. Can they do it in 49 seconds? A goal is what they want. They must win it out of the centre and win it fast. 5 points, 49 seconds. Centre bounce. Can they get it clear? Counting down. Here goes Couch. He wants to get onto the left foot. He's on it now. He spears it, but Ablett slips at the critical stage. Back almost with him again. He puts his body over the ball. They're desperate. Cordy tries to get it out. Can't do so. 32 seconds and counting. Couch, a left footer. It's in towards goal. Close. It's over the top. And one point. 1 point. 22 seconds. So the margin is now 4 points.
And what about the critics of the clock now, Sandy? This is when it counts.
It certainly does. 17 seconds and counting down. Darcy needs it. He's got it. He plays on. He goes short into the pocket.
10 seconds.
This could be the last kick of the match. Robert Scott has kicked 2 goals. The siren is going to sound. He must kick this for Geelong to win the match. The siren has sounded. The siren has sounded, and the youngster knows. 4 premiership points are hanging on this. John Devine is up out of his seat.
Poor kid, poor kid.
Let's see what he can do. Tremendous pressure, a difficult angle. The distance not a problem. The kick is a beauty.
Hit the post.
I think it's hit the post.
It hit the post.
Sydney have won. Sydney have won. What desperately bad luck for the youngster in Robert Scott. He hits the post, and Sydney has won this match. The record books will show by 3 points. Robert Scott leaves the ground.
What a...
In a simply fantastic finish, Geelong, a bit like Collingwood yesterday, off target 5-8 in the last quarter, Sydney 3-1, and Sydney hold on to win the game by 3 points. For the Swans, Morwood and Brown 4 each, and Mitchell 3, and for Geelong, Ablett got 6 and Turner 4. Robert Scott finished with 2 goals, and oh, how Geelong fans would dearly have loved to have seen one more goal added to that tally. Sydney 17-12, 114, Geelong 16-15, 111. We'll be back to wrap up today's footy action after this.
They're nice and crunchy.
I like Kellogg's Corn Flakes best.
I wouldn't change them for the world.
They don't need changing anyway because they're just perfect the way that they are.
Kellogg's Corn Flakes. The simple things in life are often the best.
You're skating, you're nuts.
You're an old Australian scallywag.
You're scratching
Australian scallywag.
You're an old Australian
scallywag.
Spaghetti sauces are made from the finest natural ingredients, deliciously blended to create the natural taste of a great spaghetti sauce. With plump tomatoes, the finest herbs. That's Dolmio. We put the good things in so you'll wear the Dolmio grin.
They're crunchy and they're delicious.
Robin, you tell me why you like cornflakes the best, mate?
Say the Simon, I suppose.
What's that?
Simple things. Because they're beautiful.
Aboriginal tribal remedies for centuries shrouded in mystery. Now scientists are discovering their secrets.
The first permanent written record of Aboriginal medicine.
Around the world in 2 hours. See how Australia is playing a key part in the development of a space plane. Plus, the science fiction dream of a car that defies gravity.
Discoveries over the last few months could eventually turn this dream into a reality.
See how the superconductor will revolutionise our entire world on Beyond 2000, presented by AMP, Tuesday night.
Well, it may have been a thrilling match down at Cadenia Park. It was also a thriller up at Carrara this afternoon as we check again the final scores. And Brisbane coming from behind with Bernie Harrison, Brad Hardy kicking behinds in the last minute to get up and win 17-11, 113. Fitzroy 16-15, 111 for Brisbane. Brenton Phillips and Kappa got four each. And for Fitzroy, Craig McGrath finished with five. Let's check the league ladder now as it stands. After round six, Carlton, Collingwood, Hawthorn and Melbourne, all with five victories. The West Coast Eagles hanging in the five with four victories. Geelong didn't lose a place today and they're in sixth spot despite the loss, with Fitzroy and Essendon both having three wins. Sydney have moved up to the next position. They're just below North Melbourne with Brisbane, and then with one win apiece, we have St Kilda, Fitzroy and Richmond. So there is the league ladder standing after round six of VFL football. Next week, a big round coming up, and it all kicks off on Friday night with the West Coast Eagles playing St Kilda under lights at the Wacker Ground in Perth. And a West Coast certain to bounce back after their defeat at the hands of North Melbourne. Geelong versus Carlton out at VFL Park. That's going to be a thriller. Geelong will be anxious to atone for today's defeat. Carlton, of course, big winners over St Kilda yesterday. Fitzroy take on Sydney in what should be an entertaining game. Melbourne and Hawthorn, Essendon versus Collingwood. And then next Sunday at the MCG, it's Richmond versus North Melbourne and Brisbane versus Footscray. So there you have it, round seven of VFL action coming up next weekend. And what an exciting day of football it has been at Cadenia Park, with Sydney just downing Geelong, and of course up there at Carrara it was the Brisbane Bears coming from behind to beat Fitzroy. A marvellous day of football here on Seven this afternoon. Hope you've enjoyed it, and of course we'll be with you with all the footy action in the weeks to come. So congratulations to Sydney Swans supporters. They haven't had a lot to cheer about. And today, certainly, there'll be plenty of celebrations up in the Harbour City. Also, congratulations to the Bears supporters. Thanks for joining us on Sunday Football. We'll look forward to your company in the weeks to come.
Who was there when they wrote the story? Who was there in the colours of glory? Who was there when a new star rose? Who was there as each chapter closed? We were there when the mighty fell. We were there when they did it well. Who was there when the boys became the men? We were there and we'll be there again.
We'll be there this year, we'll be there. We'll be there up.
A Pentridge escapee terrifies a Mooney Ponds family.
And Geoffrey Edelston looks to Melbourne for a new business future.
This is Seven Nightly News with Peter Mitchell and Kate Dunstan.
Good evening. In other news tonight, an elderly man bashed to death in reservoir.
And Jeff Kennett hits the campaign trail.
And in sport, Brisbane and the Swans scrape home in today's VFL matches. A Mooney Ponds family was terrified last night when a Pentridge escapee